Hello everyone. In this lecture, I am going to talk about thermal processing of municipal solid waste. Actually, the management of solid waste is a very essential task for the protection of public health and the environment. And for the management, various methods and technologies that are used are mainly biological treatment methods and thermal treatment methods. And in this lecture, I will mainly concentrate on all the thermal methods that are used for the management of solid waste. Now let's understand first what is thermal treatment or how thermal treatment is done of solid waste. Thermal treatment means applying high temperature for the processing of the waste or the conversion of the waste into different products. That products may be gaseous, liquid, or solid in nature, and in this process energy may be generated or may not be generated, and that thermal treatment actually reduces the volume of solid waste up to 90%. So it becomes easy to handle lesser volume of that solid waste, and also it becomes easy to transport that lesser volume of solid waste. That method is advantageous to the environment as well as to the economy because it reduces the transport cost and all that. Besides that, that method decomposes the toxic materials that are present in the waste. That method decomposes that material into different gases like carbon dioxide, water vapors, and all that. And when these are generated, then solid waste are burned out completely, and the heat that is generated by the burning of these waste that is used for other purposes, like that these are used for the electricity generation and all that. So that method is highly advantageous in nature. Now the systems used for thermal treatment. There are three systems mainly used for thermally treating the solid waste. These are incineration, and this method is also known as combustion. Second is gasification, and third is pyrolysis. Now the first thermal treatment method is incineration or combustion. In this method, waste is burned at high temperature of more than 850 degrees Celsius in the presence of oxygen in the environment. And high temperature burn the waste and produce gases. And gaseous waste mainly comprises of carbon dioxide and water vapors. Besides that, other gases like nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides are also exhausted or burning of waste. And ultimately, waste materials get converted into three components, and these are ash, exhaust gases, and heat. Ash is mostly formed by the inorganic components which are present in the waste. And sometimes these, the particles in the ash are of very small size, like that of size of particulate matter. And these particulate matter also exhausted out along with the flue gas. The flue gases are cleaned further, and then these are released into the environment. These are made pollutants free, and thereafter these are dispersed into the atmosphere. Now the gas is mainly generated due to the decomposition or the burning of the organic waste. Generally, the heat that is generated by burning of the waste that is used for the generation of electricity. Now, the objective of thermal treatment method is to reduce the volume of the waste to a great extent and also to utilize the energy that is contained in the waste. And the energy that is formed in the form of heat is utilized mainly for heating purposes, for the production of steam, and for the generation of electricity. Now the incineration process. In the whole incineration process, the waste is burned. By burning of waste, the heat which is generated, it is used for the generation of electricity. The ash which is generated, it is disposed of to the landfill site. And the exhaust gases and particulate matter that are generated into the air, and that air is cleaned up, and then pure air is released into the atmosphere. So that is the overall process that takes place in the incineration. And we can also say that there are four main components involved in the incineration process, and these are: first component is its burner or furnace. The ignition of waste at incineration plant is achieved by using it. Now the second component is boiler. In it, the energy content of the hot off gases is utilized for steam and electricity generation. Third component is system for removal of residues. These are 20 to 40% of the initial waste, and these are collected by hoppers and transferred to the specific systems for further cooling. Fourth component is the removal of suspended particles and gaseous pollutants. These gaseous pollutants may be carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxides, sulfur oxides, furans, dioxins, hydrogen chloride, hydrogen fluoride, that depending upon the composition of the waste. And these all gaseous pollutants are removed by various systems like cyclones, wet cleaning systems like scrubbers as shown in the figure, and electrostatic filters, bag filters, or these bag filters are used when collectively that is termed as bag house. Ultimately, these scrubbers and bag houses remove the suspended particles in the air and release the clean air into the environment. So this is the overall incineration process that is carried out for the burning of the waste and for the utilizing of the energy that is generated by burning of the waste. Pre-requirements for incineration. Now there are certain requirements are there which must be fulfilled for efficiently do the incineration process, and these are: there must be available adequate amount of fuel material for the combustion of the waste. The ignition temperature of the waste must be achieved so that it burn completely. Continuous removal of the gases or exhaust gases are also required, because otherwise they will fill the space and no more gases can release from the burning waste. Continuous removal of combustion residues are also essential because otherwise they can clog the incineration plant. Maintenance of suitable temperature within the furnace that is adequate for burning of the waste. Adequate retention time of the waste at the combustion area should be followed so that the waste must be completely burned. Advantages of incineration process. These are: minimum land is required as compared to the other disposal methods like that of landfilling. The weight of waste also get reduced to about 25% of its initial value, and thus the handling of waste and transportation of the waste becomes easy. And there is no risk of polluting the streams and groundwaters as happens in landfills. Landfills usually, the liquid material gets seeped down into the ground and it may contaminate the groundwaters, but here there is no risk of polluting the water. Incineration plants can be located close to the residential areas because there is no risk of pollution. And the heat that is generated due to incineration process that is used for the generation of electricity. So this is also an advantage of incineration. Disadvantages of incineration process. This process is expensive. It requires skilled labor. The gases that are released into the air that may contain strong pollutants if not properly removed and may destroy the ozone layer. And high energy requirement is also there for burning of waste. Now the next thermal method is gasification. In this process, the carbon containing materials like coal, biomass, sludge, domestic solid waste, these all are converted into a syngas or synthesis gas. This is a gas of mixture of gases or other substances, and this can be used for the synthesis of industrial chemicals. Therefore, this is termed as synthesis gas. And the various uses of that gas are: this is used for electric power generator and also used for the generation of various valuable products like chemicals, fertilizers, and it is also used as a substitute of natural gas as a fuel. Now, gasification is carried out with insufficient supply of oxygen, in contrary to incineration process, which was carried out in sufficient supply of oxygen or rich supply of oxygen, but gasification is carried out in insufficient supply of oxygen. So this is a partial oxidation process which ultimately produces syngas or synthesis gas. Now this synthesis gas comprises of different components. Like, it comprises of 30 to 60% carbon monoxide, 25 to 30% hydrogen, 0 to 5% methane, 5 to 15% carbon dioxide, water vapors, small amounts of sulfur compounds like hydrogen sulfide, carbonyl sulfide, and some ammonia and other trace contaminants. Now, actually, the composition of syngas depends upon the composition of the feedstock, and these all components varies with the different kinds of waste. That gasification process can be carried out directly as well as indirectly. Directly means a particular oxidizing agent is used for carrying out the oxidation of the biomass or the feedstock, and in the indirect gasification process, no oxidizing agent is used, but there is a need of external energy source. Gasification plant. Gasification process is carried out in gasification plant, and it mainly comprises of 5 components. These are feedstock injector, oxygen plant, gasifier, gas cleanup, and the byproducts that are released after carrying out the process. Now, the feedstock or the raw materials or the waste materials which can be treated by using that gasification plant, that may be of solid, liquid, or gaseous in nature. They are like that of solid waste, wood waste, agricultural waste, household waste. And when we talk about liquid waste, the liquid refinery residues like asphalt, bitumen, and other oil sand residues can be treated by using that gasification plant. Besides that, gaseous waste like natural gas or refinery or chemical off gas can be treated by that gasification plant. And these all kind of feedstocks can be injected into it. Now, next component is oxygen plant, and most of the gasification systems use almost pure air to help or facilitate the reaction in the gasifier. This oxygen is generally 95 to 99% pure and is generated in a separate plant, and that is termed as oxygen plant. And thereafter, that pure oxygen is fed up into the gasifier. Now, the core of the gasification plant is that gasifier. This is a pressurized vessel where the feed material reacts with oxygen and steam at high temperature. Now the feedstock that is injected into the gasifier along with controlled amount of air and thereafter the temperature that reaches into the gasifier may be up to 1400 to 2800 degree Fahrenheit. The heat and pressure inside the gasifier break the chemical bonds that are present in the feedstock and ultimately generates syngas. Typically 70 to 85% of the carbon in the feedstock gets converted into syngas. Thereafter, that syngas is enter into the gas cleanup chamber, and that gas cleanup chamber removes the impurities that are present in the syngas. Thereafter, the byproducts, most solid and liquid feed gasifiers produce a glass-like byproduct, and that glass-like byproduct is termed as slag. This is known as hazardous and can be used in roaded construction and as a roofing material. And also in most gasification plants, more than 99% of the sulfur is removed and recovered either in the form of elemental sulfur or sulfuric acid. Now, after the cleaning up of the syngas enters into the next chamber, and from here it can be recovered and can be used for various purposes, like for the generation of electricity or for the formation of various chemicals in the industries. So this is the overall gasification plant in which feedstock and oxygen, these both are injected into the gasifier. The decomposition of that feedstock takes place, that ultimately release the syngas, and syngas is cleaned up and that is further used for various purposes. Advantages of gasification. This is eco-friendly method than that of combustion process because there is a provision of cleaning up of the syngas. Furan dioxin compounds do not produce in gasification process. And the concentration of volatile organic compounds, semi-volatile organic compounds or polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons are also reported to be produced less in the case of gasification process. Now the next thermal method is pyrolysis. Pyrolysis is a non-combustion heat treatment process that chemically decomposes the waste material by applying heat. And here heat can be applied directly as well as indirectly, but in the absence of air, or if oxygen is used, it is used in very low amount. It is endothermic reaction and thus requires input of energy, and mostly that energy is applied indirectly through the valves of the reactor in which waste material is placed for treatment. The temperatures typically that reaches up in the pyrolysis are 450 to 750 degrees Celsius. And in this process, biomass undergoes partial combustion in the absence of air or in the very small amount of air. And this drives off all the volatile proportions which are present in the organic materials and ultimately results in the formation of syngas or synthesis gas. Now in the pyrolysis process, all the volatile components escape out in the form of synthesis gas, and non-volatile components generate liquid fuels. And after the process, solid residue that remains, that is called char or biochar. This is like charcoal and rich in carbon. The synthesis gas which is produced as a due to the volatile components of the waste is utilized in boilers, gas turbines, and also in internal combustion engines to generate electricity. Besides that, pyrolysis ash that is formed is used for manufacturing brick materials. Although all the products of pyrolysis may be useful, but the main fuel that is generated after the pyrolysis is pyrolysis oil, and depending upon the process, this oil may be used as liquid fuel for burning in the boiler or as a substitute for diesel fuel in the reciprocating engines. Although this normally requires further processing when we want to use it as a fuel. Besides that, liquid products produced are like tar and the oil that are generated. These are further used for the production of chemicals in the industries like methanol, acetone, etc. Thus, in the pyrolysis, all the products that are produced, these are further used for different purposes. Advantages of pyrolysis. Now, the decomposition temperature that is used in the case of pyrolysis is less than as compared to the incineration temperature. So, the thermal distress of the whole facility that is used for carrying out the process is less intense as compared to the incineration. The decomposition that takes place in the pyrolysis is in reducing atmosphere, because here oxygen is not used, or when used, it is in very less amount. But in contrary to this, oxidizing atmosphere is used in case of incineration. And due to the less demand of oxygen in case of pyrolysis, the air emissions are also less in case of pyrolysis as compared to the incineration. Now, the carbon content of the ash that is generated as a result of pyrolysis is higher as compared to in the case of incineration. And the metals that are included in waste are not oxidized during the pyrolysis and have higher commercial value. And no ash is produced from the combustion of pyrolysis gas, and the cleaning of the off gas is also a simpler process in the case of pyrolysis. Gasification plant. Gasification process is carried out in gasification plant, and it mainly comprises of five components. These are feedstock injector, oxygen plant, gasifier, gas cleanup, and the byproducts that are released after carrying out the process. Now, the feedstock or the raw materials or the waste materials which can be treated by using that gasification plant, that may be of solid, liquid, or gaseous in nature. They are like that of solid waste, wood waste, agricultural waste, household waste. And when we talk about liquid waste, the liquid refinery residues like asphalt, bitumen, and other oil. References for this presentation are these. Thank you.